Hello there. This video and the three videos after it are going to show you how to use the flowchart that's presented in this textbook to figure out the scales of measurement for all of the examples that I gave you. So let's go ahead and start with nominal. And you see we have college major, marital status, eye color, and favorite movie genre. And remember, nominal variables are categorical. They aren't really numerical at all. They're not quantitative. And you can't really put any kind of values for these variables in any sort of meaningful order. But let's use the flowchart to confirm that they are, in fact, nominal variables. So if we start with college major, okay? Is college major, and we always start here, is college major a quantified or numeric variable? So if we think about the way that data for that would look, right? It would be like psychology, business, education, not numbers. So that's a big old no. Now we ask ourselves, are values in a meaningless or arbitrary order? So if I was looking at the data, psychology, business, whatever, those different majors, could I put them in a meaningful order that's not subjective, right? As a psychologist, maybe I'll be like, psychology is number one, but that's not meaningful, right? That's just my own bias. So my answer to that question for college major, are values in a meaningless, arbitrary order? Yeah, they are. So hey, nominal and nominal variables are always discrete. Let's see if we follow the same path if we look at a different variable. If we look at marital status. So marital status, single, divorced, married, right? Not quantified, not numeric. If you put them in order, you might think that single people are the coolest or whatever, but it's arbitrary, right? It's meaningless. So again, nominal. Let's look for another one. Okay. So eye color, right? If you think about the way that data looks. Again, it's gonna be words, right? Categories. Brown, blue, green, hazel, whatever, right? Not numeric. And if you put those in order, there's no meaningful order to it, right? There's no way to say blue is a higher value than green or whatever, right? So nominal again. So now let's take a look at favorite movie genre as an example. So it depends on how you measure it, right? So if let's assume that we're measuring favorite movie genre is literally what is your favorite genre, right? Comedy, horror, drama, whatever, those categories, not numbers. If you put them in an order, it would be meaningless because it would be based on your own favorability. And if you looked at the way a graph would be in this, because when we think about an order, we're kind of thinking about if we graphed data on this x-axis, would there be a meaningful order to it, higher or lower values? And we would have like horror, comedy, and so forth. And then you'd see bars here, and those bars would just represent how frequent each category was selected, right? How often those categories were selected. So that order would be arbitrary. Whatever order you put them on the axis wouldn't matter. So nominal and discrete.